Thank you, Chairman sir. The state of Andhra Pradesh has addressed it to the central government for construction and development of port on the location of Ramayapatnam, sir. And this particular port, initially at the in the AP Reorganization Act, the government of India has originally proposed to construct a port in Dugarajapatnam. Due to non-feasibility of Dugarajapatnam port, later decision was taken to shift the Dugarajapatnam port to Ramayapatnam, sir. Sir, this Ramayapatnam port, apart from being importance of the state, also holds importance in international relevance. Sir, the two-day seminar of BIMSTEC International Conference on the development of ports with the countries adjoining to Bay of Bengal had extensively spoken about port of Ramayapatnam and its implications on trade with the BIMSTEC countries, sir. Sir, this port, the proposal is the port shall be constructed by the state government and to be funded by the central government as per the AP Reorganization Act, sir. The erstwhile state government decided to build on its own a non-major port in Ramayapatnam instead of getting a central port sanctioned by the central government of India, sir. Sir, but the present state government has a different proposal that the port shall be constructed by the state government and to be funded by the central government so that state will hold the absolute power on the port, sir. Sir, the state government has already identified 3,000 acres of land at Ramayapatnam for setting up the project, and therefore I urge the government of India to kindly expedite the process and facilitate completion of project at Ramayapatnam, as it has been 5 years since AP Reorganization Act was passed, and it is unfortunate that my party has to still raise our voices for proper implementation of AP Reorganization Act.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. See,